Have you ever looked at someone your age and thought, why do they look so much younger than me? Or maybe, why do I look older than I should? Believe it or not, this isn't just about genes. The truth is, some people are aging up to 10 times faster than others. In this video, I'm gonna walk you through exactly why this happens, what signs to look out for, and most importantly, what you can do right now to slow down or even reverse it. Hi, I'm Dr. Amir Karam. I'm a board certified facial plastic surgeon. I'm the founder and creator of Karam MD Skin. I specialize in facial rejuvenation, which basically means I help people look as young as they feel. Every week I share insights on aging, skincare, rejuvenation that ultimately simplify the confusion and help you take control of your future self. And so if you haven't already, make sure you subscribe to this channel so you don't miss out. And today we're breaking down why some people age so much faster than others. So let's get into it without any further ado. All right, so when we say someone is aging faster, it's not just about few wrinkles, it's the difference between looking vibrant, rested, tired, hollow, and older than your years. And most importantly, older than the way you feel. So here's what's really happening under the surface to cause this accelerated change. It's collagen breaking down, so skin loses firmness, fat and even bone is shrinking, leaving the face hollow. Skin is thinning, so veins and texture show through. Slow down in cell turnover leads to dullness and even changes in uneven tone and discoloration. Mitochondria, those little cellular batteries that we've been hearing so much about, they start burning out. More inflammation and oxidative stress breaking you down from the inside, essentially rusting you. So the fact is, you don't just see this in the mirror, you feel it. Makeup doesn't sit right, skin looks tired and dull no matter how much rest you get, and your reflection stops matching how youthful you feel on the inside. By your 50s, two people the same exact age can look and feel decades apart. All right, so now let's talk about the biggest culprits I see in my practice and the reason some people age 10 times faster than they should. Number one, chronic sun exposure. You've heard me say it before, I'll say it again. Our generation, I'm 51, 52 years old. Everyone I knew when they were younger were doing what? They were literally laying out, tanning, working on their beautiful sun-kissed tans, or staying in tanning salons later on, etc. But that entire generation has seen so much more sun than our current, you know, kids are, because we're so much more mindful about this topic. But the reality is, all of that early UV exposure and current UV exposure is the number one ager. It breaks down collagen, it causes pigmentation, you know, sunspots, it deepens wrinkles. It is literally the one thing that is advancing aging more than anything else. And literally any conversation on this topic has to start with sun exposure, because otherwise everything else is a non-starter. Number two, poor skincare habits. So this could be the fact that you're not using anything at all from an active skincare point of view, or that you could be using the wrong products and thinking that you're doing good skincare. All of this together causes damages to your skin barrier and accelerates the breakdown of collagen. Number three, speaking specifically about inconsistent routines, starting and stopping those important actives like retinol and antioxidants like vitamin C. And when you do that, it's literally like starting and stopping gym routines. Therefore, you never see long-term progress. Number four, smoking and alcohol use. Now, smoking, in addition to forming these, you know, vertical lines around the mouth from pursing, etc., also you see an accelerated skin aging process that happens in smokers that affects their entire face, the entire skin. More coarse wrinkles, more lines, more crepiness. These are all things that we see when people who've chronically smoked. Alcohol, on the other hand, it dehydrates the skin. It also inflames and weakens collagen. So you take these two habits and you're accelerating the aging process even further than what your genetics would have done otherwise. Number five, chronic stress and poor sleep. Cortisol, which is like acid for your skin. I don't mean to be dramatic about it, but it's not good for your skin. And it's not good for any part of your body. Chronic cortisol elevations due to stress. Now you pair that with poor sleep, which also, even after one or two nights of poor sleep, you can see how your skin feels and looks as a result. There's a dullness, there's a grayness, there's an ashen quality to the skin. So take both of these together, and now you're adding fuel to the fire. And you're truly aging from the inside out when you're exposing yourself to these variables and conditions. Next is bad diet. Again, something we've been hearing a lot about, more and more about. But what is a bad diet? Well, foods that are high in sugar, processed foods. Sugar literally caramelizes collagen. Again, I don't want to be too descriptive about it, but there's a process called glycation, which leaves your skin more dull, more sagging, and ultimately leads and advances the aging process that would ultimately be headed your way. Now, let's talk a little bit about genetics. So genetics are what you're born with. Now, there's no question there are some people who have better aging genetics, but the fact of the matter is genetics plus epigenetics, now all of a sudden you are seeing. Now, what is epigenetics? Epigenetics is the environmental interaction between your genes and your environment. You put it together and then you get an expression of that gene that could either be less magnified or more magnified and amplified because of it. A simple example, you have the potential gene for forming lung cancer. Now, if you never smoke, you're less likely to get the type of cancers that are related to smoking. Your epigenetics is calming down, right? It's downplaying your natural genetics. Now, if you have the genetics for it and you start to smoke 20, 30 years in, you end up with a lung cancer. Now, somebody who doesn't have the gene for it may go much longer or never form the cancer. So the reality is you gotta remember genes and environment together. And oftentimes you don't know what your true genetics are. So as a result, you need to be doing everything you can to control your environment the best way possible. Genetics loads the gun, but lifestyle pulls the trigger. But here's the thing I want you to keep in mind. Aging is a continuum that involves skin and shape. Skin is what we're primarily talking about here, because that you have full control over. How your skin ages, fine lines and wrinkles, collagen breakdown, discoloration, all these things totally in your control. The part that you don't have total control in is fat loss, and ultimately sagging. That's happening because of hormonal changes, the combination of low estrogen combined with the integrity or the genetics that get triggered as a result of that, suddenly you start to see the face start to slide. But that is a separate part of the aging continuum, whereas skin is equally as important as sagging, but is the one thing that is completely manageable. So here's the good news. Aging faster is not inevitable. You can slow it down, and in many ways, you can actually reverse it. So let's talk about the 5 proven levers to slow down, reverse skin aging. Number 1 is medical grade actives. And when I say medical grade, I'm not talking about something that you need a prescription for, but I'm talking about things that are going to change the genetic approach to skin. It's going to change the cellular behavior of skin in the skin cells. And what are those? Number 1, it's retinol. Number 2, vitamin C, niacinamide, certain peptides, certain botanical lighteners decrease pigmentation. You take all of these things together and you're literally working from a biochemistry point of view directly at the cell's command centers, and you're reversing the changes that are naturally happening. Retinol and vitamin C, increasing collagen production, increasing cell turnover. They are decreasing antioxidant effects of the skin or oxidative stress of the skin. Niacinamide helps improve the skin barrier, decreases inflammation, also supports collagen production. Peptides does the same thing. You know, all of these things are important, but the key to this is that you do it every single day, because remember, aging is happening. It's a continuum. It's going on. It progresses from the 20s and 30s onward, but you can't go on and off these things and expect to win and reverse the changes. And honestly, this is exactly why I developed the CareMMD trifecta, because I recognized how much my patients were struggling with getting on a good routine that wasn't super complicated, 6 to 8 steps, etc. 3 simple steps in the trifecta, couple minutes a day, twice a day, off you go, and you're getting all the things you need to improve your skin from the inside out. So what's number 2 in this anti-aging equation? Daily sunscreen. Now, you can easily argue that this should be number 1. I oftentimes will speak about it as being the number 1 thing, but daily sunscreen really should be done with no exception. And SPF 30 to 50, reapplied if you're gonna be out in the sun a lot midday. It is an absolute must-have for a wrinkle reduction or wrinkle prevention, wrinkle reversal, anti-aging, whatever you want to call it, component. Because again, sun is actively aging you, and this you want to take out of the variable here. You want to take that input away from an already prime system to make you look older. Now, let's talk about number three, which is lifestyle. Number three is another one of those things that has to be done consistently. Great sleep, stress reduction, good nutrition. I did an entire video on nutrition for you. Hydration, you know, get that water into your skin. Dehydrated skin looks dull and you know, sort of flaccid looking. These are things that you want to do on a regular basis. Treat your skin like it's part of your body. You know, if you're tired or inflamed, well, guess what? Your skin is an organ. It's going to show exactly what the body is feeling as well. If you're dehydrated, it's going to show. If you're tired, it's going to show it. I mean, we all know what we look like a night after drinking or poor sleep or a couple nights of poor sleep. I mean, we look haggard. We look tired. Bags under eyes, puffiness. It doesn't look healthy. Those are all things that you can do on your own, in your home, etc. But then there's things that you want to potentially do in the office using your dermatologist, plastic surgeon, you know, medical spa of choice, etc. And those are things that are going to stimulate collagen. Those are things like microneedling. Those are things like chemical peels, lasers. Now, be careful with what you go forward with, because some things that are too strong, like radio frequency microneedling, can actually have a negative effect on skin. And using lasers in too harsh of a way or chemical peels in too harsh of a way can actually be a negative thing for your skin. So always make sure you're in trusted hands. And I've done a number of videos on these things to give you guys good information so you can remain empowered and, you know, move forward in an intelligent and productive way. But these are things that can help prime the pump even more. So you're doing the right things in your lifestyle, your skincare, your sun protection, and then now you're accelerating the good stuff using some of these different types of modalities. All right, and the fifth one, and this is where we're on the other side of the coin now. That's when the face starts to sag. And then when it comes to volume loss, the fat loss, you do fat transfer. And then when you start to see jowling and neck laxity and all those kind of structural changes, well, there's no skincare on earth that's going to improve that. There's no lifestyle that's going to prevent that. That's where things like, you know, facelifts, and in my case, the Vertical Restore, are done to basically reposition the face back to where it was structurally. But never will the results look quite as good, and I mean this, without the beautiful skin in addition to it. So even if you're considering having a facelift at some point in the future or a Vertical Restore, make sure you continuously take care of your skin between now, then, and afterwards. You can't reverse everything with your skin in just one treatment. You can try with lasers, but the bottom line is the current is still aging you. So even if you make improvements with your lasers and chemical peels, 6 months, a year later, you're back to where you started from. Sometimes you don't have a choice in terms of where you are at the moment when you're hearing something like this, but just know that no matter where you are, ultimately, you can be improved and you can move yourself closer to looking as young as you feel. So here's a combination of people who have literally been taking great care of their skin only, no surgery, and some of our patients who have done surgery, been also taking great care of their skin. So you can see that synergy and that combination between the two of them. So what's the lesson? The lesson is it's not just about reversing damage. It's about avoiding unnecessary damage in the first place. This is a great video to share with your kids and, you know, people who are in your 20s and 30s in your life, because this gives them an opportunity to plan forward, not overdo things, not be inefficient, but just get on track with the right things. Literally do exactly what I've been doing with my wife, who has been literally on top of her sun protection and her skincare since her mid-20s, and she's 52, and her skin literally looks flawless. And that is the absolute best evidence of someone who took incredible care of their skin since she's been in her 20s. It's literally the same advice. All right, my friends, that does it. That concludes it. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you learned something. I hope you can apply it. Share it with some friends and family, as I mentioned earlier. And if you haven't already, make sure you subscribe to my channel so we can learn together, continue to empower you, and give you all the tools to navigate your journey in the most effective way. And if you're ready to take the next step or just want to learn more, make sure you check out drkaram.com and karammdskin.com to learn more about the trifecta. If you have any questions or have experiences that you would like to share in the comments section, please do. This is a community that we all share and participate in and learn from each other. So make sure you do that as well. All right, my friends, until next time, Dr. Amir Karam.